church once in a blue moon, we say, oh, God, we understand. The Lord is asking you, truly, I am your father. Where is my honor? And you know that today or Sunday, he sets apart for me. And if you honor me as a father, you must come to my house. You must come to join the brethren that is in the house. To do what? To celebrate our father. If truly, the God Almighty in heaven is our own one, is our father. He's asking me and you this afternoon, where is my word? Honor. My readings today is taken from the book of Malachi. From verse 1, I will be reading from verse 1. And we will see where the Lord is asking me and you, where is what? My honor. If we say it's our truly our father. Amen. He said, the boundaries of oracle, the things to be lifted up, of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi, my messenger. Know it that the voice of men is the voice of God. Amen. People will say, oh, it's truly that the voice of men is not the voice of God. It's when you say lie. It's when you say what the Lord did not say. That one is not the voice of God, when you begin to lie. But when you begin to say what is in the Bible, the voice of men, whether you like it or not, is the voice of God. And you cannot say to him, I am speaking to you now the word of God, which God himself cannot represent himself here and begin to say all those words to you. But he had to send me as what? As a messenger, as an his voice to tell you, this is what I am telling you today. This is what God needs to tell you this afternoon. That is what I am telling you today. Amen. And two goes on to say, I have loved you, saying the Lord. The Lord said he have loved us. How many of us that is here that will say, God did not love me? He loved you since January to these days. He kept us what? Alive. He makes all our heart desire to come to pass. We cannot say that God did not do what? Love us. He said, yet you say, how and I once will have you loved us. And we are asking God, how did you say you love me? I've been asking for thee, you didn't do it. I've been asking for thee, you didn't do it. Cast your mind back at those whose leper did not do one, who did not wake up. They will not remember again that they will look for house. They will not remember again that we buy a land in Nigeria. They will not remember again, even when they have all those words, they don't remember again. It is what? It is gone forever. Amen. And the Lord says, if you says, and where did I love you? Kept you alive alone, knowing that God really do what? Love me. Many of us today, we don't even merit it to be alive today. Because of the love that he has for us, he has to take his eyes away from all our iniquities and make us to live a better life. Amen. Don't say God did not love you. God loves you. Amen. He said, was not Esau, Jacob, brother, says the Lord. Yet I love Jacob, Israel, three sails, but in comparison with the decree of love I have for Jacob, I have hated Esau, Edom, and have laid waste his mountain, and his inheritance I have given to the junkies of the wilderness. The Lord says, because the love that I have for you, I have to hate your enemy. Those enemies that you are seeing, they are human beings like you. But they make themselves to be your enemy. Because they make themselves to be your enemy, God has to hate them and begin to do more to love you. They are human beings like you. The difference is just they make themselves to be what? As your enemy. Once they make themselves to be your enemy, God begin to hate them. Know it that anyone, if you make yourself to be an enemy to somebody, and that person the image of God, and God will say here that he will begin to hate you. Because you are doing what? You are not sure first that you are enemy to my own world, to my own image. The Lord is fighting your enemy. He doesn't care whether be your brother, whether be your father, whether be your mother. As far as he has made himself or herself to be your enemy. God can cause that person out of this earth just because of you. What love did you want God to love us? Amen. That will be more than this, that he has loved us. And number four goes on to say, he said, thou people, wretched idols, she says, we have built down, but we will return and build the wasteless place. Thou sayest the Lord of hosts, they might build, but I will tear and throw down. And men will call them the wicked country, the people against whom the Lord hath indignations forever. And here the people, he said, let the people did not boast. Those who say that you are building, except God be your side, your building will be what? It will be what? In vain. Don't say, oh, I have bought a land in Nigeria. I can set it up. I don't need God. And it is, if you say you did not need God, and you will finish that house, you will see some people does not live in that house. We need God. Amen. He said, if any washer that is washing over a country, he said, without God being what? The washman. He said, the washman will be what? He will wash in vain. Many of us, we put gate man outside our house just because thief not to come in. If God not be with you, first, now that gate man go open door for them. Amen. Now that gate man go tell them, say, the oga they has today, the madam they has today. Amen. I know the way. Except God washes over you, it is not the man we put on that gate. Many of us will say, I know what to do. I will fence my house round. Except God himself fences your house round for you. When thieves want to come to you, now you go open door by yourself for them to enter. Hallelujah, somebody. God really loves us. And he's asking me and you today, where is my honor? I pray that after this word of God, may everyone that is hearing the sound of my voice, may we repent in Jesus' name. Amen. He said, your own eyes shall see this, and you shall say, the Lord is great, and will be manifest over and beyond the board of Israel. And the Lord says, when we honor him, and when we see the greater things that he will do in our life, he will do what is beyond our what? Our imagination. That is the reason I say, our God have no limits. Me and you, we have limits, but our God have what? No limits. Amen. Don't limit your God. There is nothing that he cannot do what? He cannot do. And six goes on to say, a son honor his father. How many of us here that don't honor their father? No one. Except you are a bad child or a bad son. That will say that you will not honor your father or what? Your mother. The one who carried you for good 9 months. He suffered. There are times he will not sleep here because of you. When you are catching cold, he's always there. When you did not eat, he's panicking all over and over. Many of our parents today, they develop this heart problem. It's because of me and you. That is Euro that they does not see. Anytime we carry phone and talk to them, they don't see us. Their mind is what? Is beating fast and fast. In all this, you need to do what? To respect them. If you are here, and you have your parents, please respect them. And the Bible says, those that respect their parents, their days will be long. If you want to live on this earth where we are, if you want to live long, if you want God to add more days to your days to live, you need to respect what? Your father and your mother. No matter what they will do to you. Amen. Respect them. It's a command from God. No matter what they will say to you, respect them. Don't allow any man or any woman to deceive you and tell you that it's your mother, it's your father that is troubling what? Troubling you. A time will come, you will also be a father, you will also be a mother, and your children will also say it to you that you are the one troubling them. Amen. You will know how it is. And the Bible says, If we, the wicked, know how to give the best to our children, how much more our Father in heaven? Amen. Please and please honor your father and your mother so that your days will be long. Many of us have made a great mistake saying, I will never call my mother, I will never call my father because of what they have done. Please and please, this word of God today is a command to every one of us. Honor your father and your mother so that your day will be long on this earth. He said, and a servant is master. He said, any servant should honor what? Their master. We thank God for God. Even in our working place, some people will say, thank God I don't have a master. Everyone have a master. Amen. Let me quickly tell you, when you are working, that's your patron is what? It's your master. Whatever that he tells you to do, that is what you do. Because you honor what? Your master. If you don't honor your master, you know what it is. It's not a sin when you honor what? Your master. Because here the Bible is telling us we should also honor what? Our master. Why? Because a day we call you, we also be what? A master. Somebody will also do what? Honor you. That is the problem many of us in Africa have today. When we just look at ourselves, we look down on our master. Even in Nigeria, we say, who are you to talk to me? You are not the one that born me, that and that. Here, the Bible is telling us, we should honor what? Our master. Amen. Please honor them. Don't use your language when they tell you, because they don't understand your language, you begin to use your language to do what? To insult them. Clap for yourself and continue. The day we come, you will also be what? A master. Somebody who you did not understand the language, we also walk under you, and you will also receive the same thing. Because the Bible says, whatever a man soweth, that is whatever that he will also do what? Reap. He said, if then I am a father, here the Lord is talking to me and you. He said, if then I am your father. Listen to what he says. Here is my honor. If then I am what your father, where is my honor? I told you to furnish my house, you refuse to do. Where is my honor? I told you to bring your tithes unto my house so that there will not be what? Lack in my house, you refuse to do. He said, where is my honor? As many of us that is also working in the house of God, we don't take the work that we are doing as if what? As serious as like our own, that we are doing it for our father, not for any pastor, not for any man. And the Lord is saying, if you say that you are a teacher, you come at any time that you like. And the Lord is saying, where is what? My honor. If you honor God, any job, anything that you are doing in the house of God, you hold it well, you hold it well. You are not honoring any man, but you are honoring God. Yeah, the Father is asking us, where is my honor? Amen. Say, where is my honor? If you are an usher in the house, you come at any time that you like, anytime, nobody can talk to me. The Lord is asking you, where is my honor? Many of us, we are being bent before we do the work of God. Except we continue to beg and beg you before you say, okay, let me do it. And the Lord is saying, if you truly that I am your father, you know that that thing that you are doing, and the person is telling you to do it on his own house, is asking you, you are doing it because of me, not because of that man, not because of that woman. Pastors have never called you to say, come and sweep my house for me. Come and do this for me. But it's the house of God that we are talking about. And the Lord is saying, if you are refusing to do it, he's asking me and you, where is my honor? And if you say, I am your father. And we must honor our father, our mother. And if God is our father, our mother, we need to do what? Honor him so that our days also will be also be long of this earth. When we honor our own father. And he goes on to say it. He said, and if I am a master, where is this? Fear due me, saying the Lord of hosts told you, if then truly I am now your master, where is the due season, the due fear that you ask for me? I said it today. I said many of us, we fear men, we don't fear God. Because when you fear God, anything that you are doing in the house of God, you do it what? You do it with fear. Even when there is nobody is there, you know that you are working for your Father, not for any man. The one who holds your life. The one that will lift up our voice, our hands to, and say, our Father in heaven, everyone love that music. That song so much. We become what? Familiar. We type open our Bible, we can quote it off our hearts, our Father who art in heaven. We do it, we recite it often and often. And the Lord is saying, if you truly in your hearts that I am your Father, except you are just singing it as you are singing what? National anthem. If you are not singing it as you are singing your national anthem, and that word deep to your heart, you need to do what? You need to give him what? Respect and honor. When you come to the house of God, you know that this is our Father's house. It's our Father's house. The way you behave outside is not the way you will behave when you come to the what? To the house of God. Many of us, our Father, our physical Father is so rich. When you go to the apartment, you don't do anyhow. Amen. When you see only the chair alone in the house, you will behave yourself. Some of us that our earthly Father is so rich, when you want to enter the parlor, you pull your shoe. Amen. Before you can do what? Before you can enter. There are some fathers unseen. When you look at yourself that you are dirty, yourself, we don't allow you to sit on that chair alone. You will sit on the parlor. After all, I am. My Father didn't even tell me to sit at the parlor. You are happy. How much more your Father in heaven? How much more? And which the eyes of God is every one of us, is watching us. He sends his own angel to guide you. You go to what you come back. You talk that is your own strength. But it's your Father that is guiding what? Guiding you. You sleep, you wake up. And only on Sunday, he said, come unto my house. This place, did you see any resident? Is there anybody that is resident is here? No. My resident is not here. But your resident is not here. We record it with the name of the ministry. We know, even the Italian people know that this ministry exists here. Because we record it in the name of the ministry. And they know that we come here every Sunday to do what? To serve God. To come to our Father. To talk to our Father. To say thank you for gathering me throughout the week. I go to work, I come back. I was able to feed myself. When I was driving, I saw many accidents. I saw many ambulances were going. I was asking myself where those people are going. And you know that they are going to pick somebody. Father, I have come to say thank you that I am not among those people. I know that we all of us, every living being, is your handmaid. Because of the Lord, because you guide me and protected me, I am alive today. I will come to your house and say, Father, thank you. I know that I cannot offer anything unto you. Glad to say what? Come together to say what? Thank you. Many of us, even the women, time was past. They will see paper for granted. They will not bend down to pick it. Amen. In your own word. Your Father's house. In your Father's house. And you thought that, no, my duty is not to do that. Everybody, sometimes I begin to ask myself, why are we so proud? Why? Why are we so proud? Some people will tell you, no, I cannot sweep. I am not a woman that sweep. That one will tell us that your wife will suffer well for your hand for house. If you cannot do that in the house of God. Meaning, there is nothing. We lie down, she will be doing everything around. And which is not supposed to be so. May the Lord really do what? Help us. Yeah. When I was studying this very passage, tears were coming out of my face. I said, Father, truly, I have sinned against you in some way. I said, truly, I have wronged you in some way. I repented in some area. I said, there are some certain things I need to put in order. I vowed to myself, I repented when I was studying it. Because I know that God will never ask me of what he has not put in my hand. He will never ask you. If God had given me what? A job that I used to pay my own house rent and the tenth of it that is asking me, I will not say I late to do it. I repented. I was sharing what? Tears. I said, let the earth fall amidst the earth. I said, there is nothing from this day that I will also do and miss a day that's supposed to pay and I will not pay. That even though I forget the money I own, I will turn back and bring it. I was just weeping. I said, there are many who come to Europe the same day with me till today, they are still looking for a job. Many cannot work because they have no work, no physical help. I said, but if God had given me all those things, and this is what he's asking me of it, why will I not do what? Will not do it. Why am I holding unto what God is asking me? I said, if my parents were still alive, when my mother asked me and says, if you don't give me the car, I will not start going to church. I have to buy her a car just for her to do what? To go to church. If God is not asking me, give me my one tenth of what I have given unto you, and you are holding it. And when they said, our Father, you lift up your hand, you don't even know what you are saying. That truly, Father, is not what? In you. It's not in you. Many of us, we just package ourselves by saying it. But deeply inside our heart, it's not there. That is the reason I say it today. I say, when you have the fear of God in you, that makes you not to sin, that makes you not to cheat on your husband, never what on your wife. I said, when the fear of God is not there, I said, nothing stops you. I said, nothing stops you. If when we have the fear of God, we have to take every word that comes into our hands in the house of God, we have to take it what? Seriously. There are some people who is holding some post here in church. If they are not in church, you will notice it. You will notice it. There are some, whether they are in church, they are not in church, you will not even notice it. The one that you did not notice, meaning is not holding what? Is both very well with fear of God. The one that is holding it with fear of God, when they are absent, you will notice their absence. You will notice their absence. Because the fear of God is in them. When you have the fear of God, you are in the house of God. Somebody, your leader will talk to you, you will walk out of your leader. You are walking out of God, not your leader. You are walking out of God, not that of your leader. Because that your leader is still doing the work of his father, which also your own father. Amen. May the Lord really do what? Help us today in Jesus' name. Amen. And he goes on to say, he says, sell the Lord of hosts to you. A priest who despises my name. You says, how and in what way have we despised your name? Many of us today, we go outside there. Whenever we are talking about the ministry, we say, don't mind them. Just listen. We carry for, we call in other people. Just see what thing they want to do today. Just see what thing they want to talk today. This word is for you. Amen. Repent. It's for you. Because that person that you are bringing down is doing the work of whom? Of his father. You are not bringing that person down, but you are bringing God down. You are bringing God down. You are not being what hindrance for another person. When you are praying, we say everything that will be in our hindrance, Holy God, fire. And when things begin to happen to us, many of us, we don't sit down and say, where this problem comes from? There are sometimes I pray and pray, when this, my prayers think that no answer, I sit down to think, to look where it's coming from. Then I will go to the root. If you say you want to cut a tree, you want the tree to die, you don't cut the up, the tree will not die. Except you go to what? To the roots. I go to the roots. I begin to ask myself questions. Is there any area that I have wrong? Is there any area that I have done something that is not good? I pray and I say, Father, open my eyes to see it. And when you God open your eyes to see it, if it is gossiping, I say, Father, I am sorry. I will not do it what? Again. Then you see yourself, those problems begin to do what? Begin to leave you. Many of us, when things are happening to us, it things that we cause to ourselves. We thought that we are ready. We thought that nobody sees us when we are doing all those things. But the eyes of God is on us. The eyes of God is on us. When the problem comes, look at what you are doing that making those problems to do what? To cause to you. Stop calling people and polluting what? Their hearts. People love that doing it. Then we call the words that they will use. We say, don't listen. And you will be among them. That is the worst of it all. You are mom. You are mom and say, Mama, carry on. And you are seeing the same person we carry for and tell somebody, just listen to what they will say. Hypocrites, people. Repent, because the eyes of God is on you. It's on you. Repent. That is what is happening in that Nigeria that making our country not to settle. People that will say, the one that will say, let's do it in this way. The person will say, okay, now this way we want to see, let's do it, no problem. It goes. And the same person go carry and go out. You say, you hear what they say they want to. But you will be among the people. Amen. Amen. You will be among the people. If you are a worker in the house of God, and you are still the same person who is carrying the word of outside and say those people that don't know what they are doing, this is how they're supposed to do it, this is how they're supposed to do it. You are working for devil. Because you are more work the workers. Why can't you work it in a perfect way? So that others will do what? We also follow you. You get in the meeting, you kept quiet. But when you go outside, you open your mouth. They didn't make you a worker outside. They make you what? A worker inside house of God. May the Lord help us. May we grow more than their ways. When those words of pollution comes, the Lord will frustrate their ways in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We will not even listen to them because we know the call that we are serving.
Amen.
Except Christ is not in you. Nobody as a young soul, by the grace of God, for the state I have, am in the Christ. Nobody will come and pollute my heart concerning the things of God. Nobody. And that person will never be born in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Nobody. Except when Christ is not in you, somebody will come and deceive you and say, this is what the pastor is saying. This is what that one is saying. This is what that one is saying. Somebody is not describing your own mother for you. There is an error. Amen.
Amen.
There is an error. Somebody will come and say, oh, your mother look like this. Describing your mother for you. You are not knocking your head. There is an error. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Like some people, you are here in Italy. Somebody in Nigeria who have never come to Italy is not describing your city for you. There is an error. He will not tell you your church station where he is, and you will not say, nah, 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 there is it. There's an error. May the Lord help us. And I believe that God Almighty, who have brought these works unto us, He will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And number 7 goes on to say it. He said, by offering polluted food upon my altar. And you ask, how have we polluted it and profaned you? By thinking that the table of the Lord is contemptible and may be despised. When you, priests, offer building, blind animal for sacrifice, is it not evil? There are some of us, we have that note. We say we are Christian, our Father in heaven is our Father. But we are not coming to do offering. We bring coins, we leave the notes. When we go outside there, they call us for party, we begin to throw it up. Amen. Amen. Are you not done evil? And the Lord is asking. Amen.
Amen.
Are you not done evil? Because you thought that nobody, God does not see you. Let me do it. God does not see me. When we talk about to open it wide, you will see some people coming out. Amen. Then we hold it like this so that we will know the note that they are holding. Amen.
Amen.
Hypocrites. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us give you an envelope. We will put 5 euro inside. Because nobody sees that. Amen.
Amen.
Let us go. Let come and drop it. Open it. You will see it. You will bring 100 euro, 200 euro. You will bring it out. Amen.
Amen.
Who do you think that you are deceiving? You are deceiving yourself. Amen.
Amen.
You are deceiving yourself. Those people does not even mind what you are bringing or not. Amen.
Amen.
Give unto God, he says, you are not saying, you have brought offering, polluted things to my altar. And you are saying, where did I brought polluted things to my altar? He said, you have the best goats. You didn't bring those goats to sacrifice for me. You look for the one where they seek. You bring it. And you are telling me that you have not done what? Evil. And you say, I am what? Your Father. If I am your Father, where is my honor? If you want to honor me, is it not the best of your goats that you will bring to make sacrifice for me?
Yes, sir.
It's asking me and you. Not only you. I said, when I was reading it, I repented in some area. I wept. It will tell you that this one was also the one talking to me. I was just weeping. I said, I thought that I am the best giver. I said, Father, I have never started. I started weeping. I said, Lord, forgive me. And he goes on to say, in the big part of it, on number 8 of it, he said, when you offer blind animals for sacrifice, is it not evil? He's asking me, are you? And when you offer the lamb and the sick, is not evil? You know that that animal is the sick one. You want to use it to do what? To offer to God. Many of us say, thank God, we know they use sheep and whatever to offer. Just listen. Amen. He said, present such a thing, a blind or a lamb or sick animal, now to your governor in payment of your tithes, and see what will happen. Amen. He said, take those things to your own God. Governor says you want to pay your tithes. You want to pay tax. I bring this goat where they seek and see what will happen. And the Lord is still telling me, and you. And he says, we are what? Children of the Most High God. We are taking coins, red, the worst from red one. Amen. Are we not doing evil? Are we not polluting the altar of God? It's not when people will say, oh, when prostitutes bring the money to the altar of God, we polluted the altar. Now, no, it's you too. When you bring something that is not right to the altar of God, you are still doing what? Polluting the altar. What makes me so much weep so much? When I was doing my birthday, I told my sister, this year I will do it loud. I will bring I will carry Nigeria plates, come to Italy to eat. We use 150 euro to bring the beer bar. But I said my thanksgiving, what I used to thank God, was not up to 150 euro. And that makes me to weep. Amen. That makes me what? To weep. I said, why have I done this? I said, Father, forgive me. If I can use 150 euro to bring a beer bar from Nigeria, just to show or to feed people, I'm the God that added the day to my day, the reason of my celebration, I am not able to give more than that unto God. I said, shame unto me. I was weeping. I was weeping. I said, what have I done? I was weeping. Many of us today, we can invite for the whole world and feed the whole world. But when we want to thank God, that is the one who makes us to celebrate. Many have raised their birthday, their marriage, but they did not sleep to see the day to celebrate. They did not live to see the day. I was just crying. I said, Father, forgive me. I was asking for what? Forgiveness. I thought that I was ready. I said, people were saying, Mama, we will put this. Mama, we will put it on. So that we will make it small. We will make it right. I was making a gun thinking that I was doing what? The best. When this word comes, it's opened my eyes to know what I have done. I weep. I say, Father, forgive me. Many have arranged their building. They did not live to see it. Many marked 2 months to their birthday. They did not live to see the birthday. May the Lord really help us. Many borrow money to do marriage, but when it comes to give to God, they will say, I will not go into borrowing because of God. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. And I believe that God Almighty, He will help us. He will forgive us all our sin. We all have wronged God in one way and the other. We have wronged God. He will forgive us. If truly our repentance will be what? Sincere. He will help us. He said, will we be pleased to you? Or will He receive you gloriously, says the Lord of hosts. Now then, entrust God that will be glorious to us with His a gift from your hands as a fitting animals for sacrifice. We have accepted it and show favor to any of you, says the Lord of hosts. Amen. No one will give something that is not good to his own father. Let's rise on our feet. If I be your father, where is my honor? The Lord God Almighty, our Heavenly Father, is asking me and you today, if He be our Father, where is His honor? Amen. And today, we set it apart to anoint ourselves. The anointing that will take us, that will catapult us to 2022. Amen. Collect our oil. We are going to pray and tell it unto God, any area that we are not doing it right, the Lord should forgive us. That the Lord should break away every poverty. The Lord should break it away from us. let us be fast and collect our oil we are praying. There is nothing that he cannot do. Today, Father Lord, King of glory, we have come with the hearts of repentance. Forgive us on our sin. And from today, Lord, we will honor you, Lord, with our words, with our time, with our body, with everything, Lord, that you are giving unto you. Father Lord, we say thank you. Father Lord, King of glory, in financial ways, O Lord, Father, as we use this oil, Lord, O God, let the door of financial breakthrough be open unto every one of us that we use this oil in the authority name of Jesus. Everyone, Lord, that we use this oil, so Lord, it will not know lack, O Lord.
Amen.
He will not weep to enter 2022.
Amen.
He shall enter 2022 with life.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father Lord, as we using this oil, Lord,
amen.
Christmas is drawing closer and closer. Father Lord, our blood will not be used for sacrifice.
Amen.
Our children's blood will not be used for sacrifice.
Amen.
Our flesh will not be used for sacrifice.
Amen.
Our children's own will not be used for sacrifice.
Amen.
Our husband's own will not be used for sacrifice.
Amen.
Our wife's own will not be used for sacrifice.
Amen.
Father, we will never be used for sacrifice.
Amen.
Wherever men will be forced, oh Lord, our spirit, may the fire of God answer them.
Amen.
Wherever they call our name in any weird dark where we are not dear, to inform our spirit, oh Lord, oh Lord. Masika tabaro sokoto. May the fire of God answer them.
Amen.
By the use of this oil, oh Lord, oh God.
Amen.
Father, Lord, King of glory, we will become untouchable.
Amen.
We will become untouchable.
Amen.
We will become untouchable.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our children will become untouchable.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Father, because we have used this oil, Father, when we sleep, oh Lord, oh God, the nightmare, oh Lord, oh God, but that God, we will become untouchable for them to press.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we use this oil,
amen,
every pregnant woman, everyone that are looking for the fruit of the womb, the Lord God Almighty will be with you.
Amen.
Your children, your baby in your womb will become untouchable.
Amen.
They will become untouchable.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the using of this oil,
amen,
that you are looking for the fruit of the womb,
amen,
as if this month will never pass you by.
Amen.
This month will be your month.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are you being the one that's oil miscarriage because of this oil?
Amen.
As
be terminated.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Are you still as part of your document? By the raising of this oil,
amen,
this land,
amen,
where you are seeking document from,
amen,
he will favor you with document.
Amen.
Are you still looking for a job? By the using of this oil,
amen,
this land,
amen,
where you are looking for a job,
amen,
he will favor you with a job.
Amen.
Are you asking God to heal you? In this land where you are, this land of Italy, by the using of this oil, you will be healed.
Amen.
I say you are delivered.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
As you use this oil,
amen,
you are blessed.
Amen.
As you use this oil, you are blessed.
Amen.
As you use this oil, you are blessed.
Amen.
God Almighty has pronounced blessing upon you.
Amen.
And no man will curse you.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
Let's shout our two names together for Jesus. Please let quickly bring the children unto me. Amen. Amen. Children. In this land we will excel. In this land you will excel. This land will not swallow you, you will excel. This land will not swallow you with itself. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Let's jump our hands together for Jesus. Our Lord is good all the time. Amen. Before we say our